send individual letters to every business establishment. Tell them they're not going to be blocked. They can see you as well. Play it down.
Francois Mitterrand.
So.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan. Standing as the guards of the French Republic Band play the national anthem of the Republic of France.
Américain. Le France était à vos côtés pour la conquête de votre
de la liberté, symbole aujourd'hui de la première de nos valeurs communes. À votre tour, vous êtes venu.
Il n'y aura pas de repos d'ici là pour ceux qui croient que rien ne vaut d'être vécu. Sentiment qu'éprouve à leur égard la nation française et la fierté, porte-parole d'une amitié plus forte que les épreuves du temps. À vous enfin. Happy birthday, Miss Liberty.
Thank you.
Mitterrand, Madame Mitterrand, distinguished guests, and fellow Americans. As Secretary of Transportation, it is...
...to the restored Statue of Liberty, the symbol of freedom and hope for all mankind. The statue has particular relevance to the many immigrants whose first glimpse of America was the sight of that towering cathedral to liberty, that monument to hope. Future generations, by remaining strong as a nation, by making plain our determination never to let our freedom slip away.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. From millionaires and school kids, from companies and civic groups, from people in Europe and from people behind the Iron Curtain, even from Vietnamese boat people, it came.
Thank you, and Lee Iacocca, thank you on behalf of all of America. President, Madame Mitterrand, John, we are, the leader of the French workers, said his countrymen understood. After all, he asked, how would Frenchmen feel if Americans showed up to help restore the Eiffel Tower? But as the people of France, this statue came from their pockets and from their hearts. The French workers, too, made discoveries. Monsieur Weyard, for example, normally lives in a 150-year-old cottage in a small French town. But for the last year, he's been riding the subway through Brooklyn. A study in contrasts, he said. Contrast indeed. But he has also told the newspapers that he and his countrymen learned something else at Liberty Island. Irish, Russian, Polish, and Indian backgrounds. Fascinating, he said, to see different ethnic and national types work and live so well together. People of every nation could live together as one. It's especially fun. The French and American people have forged a special friendship over the course of two centuries. Yes, in the 1700s, France was the midwife of our land.
And yet, my fellow Americans, it is not only the friendship of two peoples, but the friendship. I thought about my grandfathers coming through here. And which of us does not think of other grandfathers?
Look up. She was beautiful. Another talked of how all the passengers rushed to one side of the boat for a fast look at their new home. The whole boat bent toward her. She was beautiful with the early morning light. The million captain of artillery described how on a troop ship returning from France, even the most hard-bitten veteran had trouble blinking back the tears. Wrote to his fiancée, Bess, back in Independence, Missouri, as the Liberty Lady in New York Harbor. And that's why tonight we celebrate this everybody's gal. We sometimes forget that even those who came here first to settle the new land were also strangers. I've spoken before of the tiny Arabella.
The eyes of all the world were upon them, and that they must not forsake the mission that got under the nations of all the world, a shining city upon a hill. Call it mysticism, if you will.
It will surely cast its glow upon her, as it has upon us for two centuries, keeping faith with a dream of long ago, and guiding millions still to a future of peace and freedom.
Thank you, and God bless you all. Nancy?
Thank you. stay up?
Anybody else?
Want to stay up?
No.
Yes.
No. Okay.
Absolutely.
All right, I'll come right back.
Born in Costa Rica.
I just checked with the producer on the podcast. He said that you landed the eye of Coca.
He showed signs of great musical ability at a tender age, and an attack of polio when he was four did nothing to diminish. Canal zone of Jamaican parents, Kenneth Clark immigrated to New York's Harlem in 19... 19- The family of Albert Sayer. His work was one of the main contributing factors to the eradication of that deadly disease around the world. At 80, he still actively crusades for causes that benefit mankind. The Medal of Liberty is awarded tonight to Dr. Albert Sayer. From Shanghai in 1945, An Wang began a career in England in 1903.
take with them when they leave fond memories of this historic occasion. I know they will take with them the gratitude and affection of the American people.
Are also those whose names are remembered by only a few. Many of them passed through this harbor, went by this lady, looked up at her torch, which we light tonight in their honor. They were the men and women who labored all their lives so that their children would be well fed, clothed, and educated. The families that went through great hardship yet kept their honor, their dignity, and their faith in God. They passed on to their children those values. Values that define civilization and are the prerequisites of human progress. They worked in our factories, on ships and railroads, in stores and on road construction crews. They were teachers, lumberjacks, seamstresses, and journalists. They came from every land. What was it that tied these profoundly different people together? What was it that made them not a gathering of individuals, but a nation? That bond that held them together as it holds us together tonight, that bond that has stood every test and travail, is found deep in our national consciousness, an abiding love of liberty. For love of liberty, our forebears, colonists few in number and with little to defend themselves, fought a war for independence with what was then the world's most powerful empire. For love of liberty, those who came before us tamed a vast wilderness and braved hardships which at times were beyond the limits of human endurance. For love of liberty, a bloody and heart-wrenching civil war was fought. And for love of liberty, Americans championed and still champion, even in times of peril, the cause of human freedom in far-off lands. The God who gave us life, Thomas Jefferson once proclaimed, gave us liberty at the same time. But like all of God's precious gifts, liberty must never be taken for granted. Tonight, we thank God for the many blessings he has bestowed on our land. We affirm our faithfulness in his rule and to our own ideals, and we pledge to keep all alive the dream that brought our forefathers and mothers to this brave new land. On this theme, the poet Emmett Lazarus, moved by this unique symbol of the love of liberty, wrote a very special dedication 100 years ago. The last few lines are ones we know so well, set to the music of Irving Berlin. They take on tonight a special meaning. Under the nations. And so, with joy and celebration, and with a prayer that this lamp shall never be extinguished, I ask that you all join me in this symbolic act of faith, this lighting of Miss Liberty's torch.
never said the Navy goodbye.
Yep. Thank you.
just walk around that way, ma'am, and we'll be safe that way. Yeah, go forward on the port side there, please.